Krishna 敬拜 Guru Dev，
请接
受卑微的敬拜。
Hare Krishna 敬拜你。Sati 在吗
？Hare Krishna Guru Dev 我在。
好。你还好啊？OK， 我们开始。
好的，好的，我们可以开始的。
Om Agyana Timarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschacha Desatarine Vanchakaupa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare So we're going through the fifth canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, and we're on chapter number 20, which is entitled Studying the Structure of the Universe.
我们继续学习圣典薄伽瓦堂第五篇第二十章，这一章的标题是宇宙结构的研究。
The Sukadeva Goswami is describing about some very special parts of the universe, which we don't know about very much from our place here on earth, but which are very important in the universe.
Sukadeva Goswami 向我们描述了在宇宙上的其他的一些很重要的地方，这些地方在我们现在这个星球上并不被熟知和了解，但是这些地方对我们来说很重要。
So he was describing about five islands which are situated here in this universe.
Sukadeva Goswami 描述了一些岛屿在这个宇宙上所存在的一些岛屿。
Not on this planet Earth, but they're within the Bhumandala.
就在这个地球，在这个 Bhumandala 的这个星系之内。不是在这个地球上，但是在这个布曼达拉星系之内。
And the inhabitants there all have very special qualities.
在那里，那里的居民有一些很特别的品质。
For example, they live a very long time, and they have great physical and mental strength.
比如说，他们有很长的寿命，身体非常的美丽，很有力量。
And they're very intelligent and very brave.
他们非常有智慧，而且非常勇敢。
嗯。So this is especially true in this island, which is called Plakshadweep.
他们所存在的这个岛屿叫做 Plakshadweep.
So Plakshadweep is surrounded by an ocean of sugar cane juice.
Plakshadweep 是被这个甘蔗之洋所环绕。
And then there's another island, Samalidweep.
还有一个岛屿叫 Samalidweep.
And that's twice as big as Plakshadweep.
它比这个 Plakshadweep 有两倍大。
And it's surrounded by water.
被纯净的这个水环绕。
But that water tastes like alcohol, like some liquor.
但是那个水的滋味是像酒一样的酒精一样的滋味。
So on this Somali Dweep, there's a Somali tree,
在 Samali Dweep 那里有一棵树叫 Samali 之树。
That tree is very broad and tall, just like the Plaksha tree on the Plaksha Dweep Island.
那棵树又宽而且又高，就像 Plaksha Dweep 上面的 Plaksha 树一样。
Right, and the people say that that tree is the residence of Garuda, the king of birds.
据说那个树那那一棵树是 Garuda 所居住的那一棵树。
And in that tree, Garuda offers prayers to Lord Vishnu.
在那棵树上 ，Garuda 向主 Vishnu 供奉祷文。
So the master of that island is one of the sons of Maharaj Priyavrata.
这个岛屿上的主人也是 Maharaj Priyavrata 王的一个儿子。
And he divided.The island into seven pieces among his seven sons.
他把这个岛屿分为七个部分，因为他有七个儿子，分给了这七个儿子，每人得到一个部分。
Right, and we heard about this actually, and there were seven mountains and there were seven rivers also on that island.
那里有七座山，同样也有七条河流。
And the inhabitants of these islands, they all worship the Supreme Lord named Soma, who is the moon god.
那里的居民他们都崇拜 Soma 神 ，Soma 是月神。
So the inhabitants of the Somali Dweep, they worship the moon god with a special prayer.
那里的居民崇拜月神，用一种特别的祷文。
There were, you know, the moon god. Of course, moon god is a demigod, but they worship him as a part of the supreme lord.
虽然月神是半神人，但是他们把月神当作至尊主的一部分。
And they worship him, saying that you've divided.By his rays, he's divided the month into two halves. One is the dark month, and one is the light part, and one is the dark part of the month.
根据您的仁慈，您划分时间，您把时间划为两半，一部分是有光的一部分，一部分是黑暗的部分。
And he also divides time.But because he's the moon god, he's able to divide time.
因为他是月神，他也划分时间。前面他是划分这个月份，后面他是划分这个时间。
And he's the king of all the residents of the universe.
而且他也是整宇宙居民的国王。
So they pray to the moon god that he will remain the king and he will guide them.
他向月神祈祷，请你继续当我们的国王和向导。
Then there's another island called Kusha Dweep.
另外一个岛屿叫 Kusha Dweep,
which is twice as big as the ocean of alcohol.
这个 Kusha Dweep 有两倍的这个九只羊那么宽，那么大。
Somali Dweep was surrounded by alcohol, an ocean of alcohol, and Kusha Dweep is surrounded by an ocean of liquid ghee.
Somali Dweep 是被这个九只羊环绕，但是这个 Kusha Dweep 是被这个酥油环绕。
Kusha Dweep, there's Kusha grass.
Kusha Dweep 那里有很多的 Kusha 草。
Kusha grass was created by the demigods because they use it in yagya.
枯沙草是半神人所造，他们用这个枯沙草来做祭祀。
Yeah, because when it's burned, it has very mild and pleasing flames.
因为当这个枯沙草燃烧的时候，非常的温和和悦人。
Then there was another son of Priyavrata. He was the king of this island, and he also divided it into seven parts, and he shared it to his seven sons.
Maharaj Priyavrata 另外一个儿子，他也在这个岛屿上作为国王，他然后把这个岛屿分为七个部分。
And then he, when he gave the land to his sons, then he retired to do austerities.
他把这岛屿划分为七个部分给他七个儿子之后，然后他就从家庭生活中隐退，开始从事苦修。
So there were seven islands. There were seven islands and seven mountains and seven rivers.
同样也有七座山，七条河流。
And the people on this island, they're all like Brahmins, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Sudras.
在这个岛屿上的这些居民，同样也有 Brahma, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Sudra.
And they're very expert in performing the Vedic rituals.
他们也非常擅长于从事伟大的仪式。
And they worship the Lord as the demigod of fire.
他们崇拜主的火神的形象。
And they have a special mantra by which they worship him.
他们也有一个特别的祷文崇拜。
They pray to the fire god that you are a part of the supreme lord.
他们向 火神祈祷，您是至尊人格守神的一部分。
And when we offer sacrifice, you carry everything to him. You bring the sacrifices we make. We offer them to you and you take them to him.
我向祭祀供奉祭品，但是您把这个祭祀中的供奉给至尊人格守神。
So they pray that whatever we offer to the Lord, whatever yagnas we do, you please offer them to the Lord for his enjoyment.
因此，我请求您，无论我们向您供奉什么，请把这些供奉给至尊主。
Because he's the supreme enjoyer, he's the real enjoyer.
因为他是真正的享受者，他是至尊的享受者。
Demigods are they're servants of the supreme lord.
半神人是至尊主的仆人，他是他的助手。
They're like the tax collectors who collect the money from the people. So the tax collector he has to bring the money and give it to the government.
这些办事人就像这个税收官一样，他们从人民那里收税，但是呢，他们收来的这个税是给予政府。
The tax collector can't think this money is mine. He has to give it to the government.
税收的部门的人，他们绝不能说这个钱我收来了之后就是我的，他们必须把钱收完之后给予政府。
So when they offer the Vedic sacrifice.The demigods cannot take it for themselves. They have to bring it to the Supreme Lord.
在祭祀活动中，这些办事人他们不能自己享受这些祭祀中的贡品，他们得把这些贡品供奉给至尊主。
So the demigods are faithful servants, and they hand over everything to the Lord.
因此，这些办事人是忠诚的仆人，他们把这祭祀活动中的一切上交给至尊主。
So if we worship the demigods in that way, there's nothing wrong.
因此，如果我们以这种理解去崇拜半神人的话，并没有错误。
But if we worship them thinking the demigods are supreme, then this is very wrong.
但是，如果我们崇拜半神人是以至尊的这种理解去崇拜半神人的话，这是错误的。
Right. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita.Kamaistaistya Rita Jnana Prapajante Naradama, right? One whose mind is distorted by material desires will worship the demigods to get temporary benefit.
那些崇拜半神人呢，实际上是被偷走了智慧的人。他们所得到的这个，他们所得到的结果非常的短暂，有限。
People of less intelligence, they worship the demigods.
那些缺乏智慧的人，他们会崇拜半神人。
And they think they are the supreme.
他们会认为他半神人是至尊。
Or they think all the gods are the same, they're all one. They don't understand there's one supreme god over everyone.
他们或许也会认为这些所有的神都是一样的，都是一。都是相同的，但是他们不了解有一个真正的至尊在他们之上的这个至尊的神。
So then there's another island called Kroncha Dweep.
有另外一个岛屿的名字叫 Kroncha Dweep.
So Kroncha Dweep was surrounded by butter Kshatriya is surrounded by milk.
前面提到的这个库沙对普这个岛屿被酥油环绕，而这个康彻对普是被牛奶环绕。
And there's a big mountain called Kruncha, Mountain Kruncha.
在这个岛屿上也有一座山叫 Kruncha 山。
And that mountain was destroyed by Kartikeya, the son of Shiva.
这个山 被这个 Kartikeya 武器所攻击而毁灭。
So the ruler of that island is also another son of Priyavrata.
统治这个岛屿的人也是 Priyavrata 王的另外一个儿子。
And he also retired from family life and took shelter of the Lord.
他也从家庭生活中隐退，然后托庇于至尊主。
And this way became perfect.
以此达到了完美。
So, again, there were seven mountains, and he had seven sons, and he divided everything. There were seven rivers, the same thing.
同样的，也有七座山，七座山，七条河流，同样的。
And the people in this island, they also worship the Lord by offering palmful of water at the lotus feet of Varuna.The demigod of the ocean.
他们通过捧上圣河的之水来崇拜至尊人格守神，崇拜这个瓦朱纳。
The Varuna is a demigod who has the form of water.
瓦朱纳是拥有水的神体形体的半神人。
Just like when we go to Ganga, we offer water, we take water in our palm, and then we offer it to the river, we offer it back into the Ganga.
就像我们去这个恒河的时候，我们会把这个河水捧到手心里，然后再把这个水倒出去，然后供奉给这个恒河。
So the people from Kruncha-dweep, they worship with a special mantra.
Kruncha-dweep 的居民他们崇拜的时候也有一个特别的曼陀罗。
Yeah, they say that, oh, your river, your water, the water of this river is energy from the Supreme Lord, that you've got your energy from the Supreme Lord.
他们说河水啊，您从至尊人格守神那里获得能量。
And so you purify the three planetary systems.
因此您净化了三个星系。
Right. In the universe, we have these three very special planetary systems. There's Bhuloka, where we are. There's Bhuvarloka, and there's Swarloka. Swarloka is the higher planets.
我们学到了有三个星系，一个是 Bhuloka, Bhuvarloka, and Swarloka.
And this God can take away all of our sins. This water, which we touch, when we touch the water, it can take away our sins. So they pray, please kindly purify us, take away our sins.
河水啊，靠您的这个本性，只是触碰您，您就可以拿走我们的这个罪恶。因此，请继续净化我们。
So the energy of the Lord.Is acting through all the different elements of the material world.
主的能量以这个物质世界的各种形式展示在这个物质世界。
And the rivers which are mentioned in the Shastra, they're also energies of the Supreme Lord.
在经典中也描述到这个水也是至尊主的一个能量。
So people, we know.Our devotees like to go to Ganga, but bathing regularly in the Ganga, you become very peaceful and clear, and mind is satisfied.
就像我们的奉献者，我们也经常看到奉献者喜欢去恒河沐浴。这个恒河可以治愈疾病，同时也可以净化身心。
So outside the ocean of milk, there's another island called Shakadweep.
在这个牛奶之洋外面还有另外一个岛屿叫沙克队。
Yeah. And Shakadweep is surrounded by yogurt.
Shakadweep 被酸奶之洋所环绕。
And in Shakadweep, there's a big shaka tree, a very big, huge shaka tree.
在 Shakadweep 上有一棵巨大的树叫沙克树。
And this tree has a very nice smell, and this fragrance, the smell of this tree, it goes all over the island.
这一棵树非常的芬芳四溢，它将这个芬芳遍布整个岛屿。
And the master of this island is also one of the sons of Priyavrata.
这个岛屿的统治者也是 Priyavrata 王的一个儿子。
And he had also seven sons.So he divided his land among the seven sons.
他也有七个儿子，于是他将岛屿分成七个部分，给予他的七个儿子。
And then he retired to take shelter of the Supreme Lord. He entered the forest for meditation.
然后他就从这个家庭生活中隐退，将心意完全专注于至尊主的莲花族。
And there were also mountains, seven mountains, and seven rivers.
在这个岛屿上，同样也有七座山、七条河流。
And these people also, they divided themselves into four castes, just like in our Varnashram, Brahma, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. They also had four castes.
这个岛屿上的居民同样也有四个阶层的划分，就像我们的Brahma, Sudra, Vaishya, Kshatriya。
And they practiced pranayama and mystic yoga, and they would do meditation on the Supreme Lord in the form of Vayu.
这些岛屿上的人们修习的是 pranayama 和神秘瑜伽，他们在神殿中崇拜以 Vayu 形体出现的至尊主，就是以风的形体，空气的形体。
And so they worship the Lord in the form of Vayu with a special mantra.
他们崇拜这个 Vayu 的形体出现的至尊主，用一个特别的曼陀罗。
They would pray that, oh, you are the Supreme Lord, you are the Super Soul within the body.
他们祈祷到，哦，您是至尊主，您是居于超灵居于体内的，您以超灵形式居于体内。
And you control also the airs within our body, like the prana which is in our body. You control it.
您控制着我们身体的各种气体，就像这个 prana, 呼吸。
So you maintain all the living entities in this way.
您以这种方式维系着所有的众生。
So they pray, may you protect us from all dangers.
请您保护我们免于所有的危险。
So through the practice of pranayama, the yogi can control the air within the body to maintain his life and to keep healthy.
通过 pranayama 的瑜伽练习，瑜伽师可以控制体内的空气，以维持躯体的健康。
And this way, the yogi can come to meditation. He can see the super soul in the heart.
以这样的方式，瑜伽师可以达到神定的程度，然后可以看到超灵。
So like that, we can absorb ourselves to see the Supreme Lord as the super soul within the heart.
我们可以通过在这个体内不断的观察，最终找到这个体内的超灵，至尊的这个超灵在我们的内心。
Then outside the ocean of yogurt is another island.Called Pushkaradweep.
在这个酸奶之洋的外面有另外一个岛屿叫 Pushkaradweep.
And it is surrounded by an ocean of very nice, tasteful water.
这个岛屿被一汪非常美味的水所环绕。
And on Pushkaradweep, there's a great lotus flower which has 100 million pure.Golden petals.
在 Pushkaradweep 上有一朵巨大的莲花，有十万个纯金的花瓣。
不是十万，100 million, 十一。 Million.
Million.
10亿。十亿 pure golden petals as effulgent as the flames of fire.
有十亿个纯金的花瓣，它们的火焰像，它们的火焰非常的灿烂。
So this is like the sitting place of Lord Brahma. Lord Brahma was born from the lotus flower.
这朵莲花被认为是主 Brahma 的座位。
Then in the middle of that island is a great mountain, a big mountain.
在这个岛屿的中央有一个巨大的山。
That makes a boundary between the inner and the outer side of the island. There's the inner part of the island, the outer part. There's a mountain between them.
在sorry.
There's a mountain between the inner side of the island and the outer side of the island.
这座山在这个岛屿的中间和外面都有这座山。
And on that mountain, there are the residences of demigods like Indra.
在这座山上有 Indra 这样的居民，有 Indra 这样的半神人，就是在这里。在这些山上是这个像英爪这样的半神的居所。
And the sun god, he has his chariot, and he rides, he travels on the top of this mountain.
太阳神的战车在这个山顶上。
And in this way, the sun god, he goes around Mount Meru.
太阳神在这个山顶上。旅行环绕着梅乳山，在山顶上旅行。
So when the sun is on the northern side, then it's called Uttarayana.
当太阳在北边的时候，被称为 Uttarayana.
And when it's on the southern side, it's called Dakshinayana.
当太阳在南边的运行轨迹的时候，被称为 Dakshinayana.
So one side is the day for the demigods, the other side is the night.
所以一半是半神人的白天，另一半是半神人的夜晚。
So the sun for 6 months is on the northern side, 6 months is on the southern side.
有六个月在北边，有六个月在另一半。
And this is like this is like one day and one night for the demigods in the upper planet. For the demigods, this is just one day and one night. But for us, it's 1 year.
对于我们来说是一年，对于半神人来讲是那里的一天和一夜。
There's a special festival coming when the sun moves, when it changes direction from the south, it comes to the northern hemisphere.It's moving when the sun moves from when it stops moving in the south and it comes to move to the north. At that time, that's a festival. What's the name of that festival? Makar Sankranti or something. It's a special name. And we can read about Bhishma leaving the body. He waited for the sun to change direction before he left the body.
From the south to the north. Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
当太阳从南边向北边正式开始运行的那一天是一个很特别的节日。那个节日一下子不知道叫做什么哈。但还有一个引述就是当 Bhishma Deva 要离开躯体的时候，他也是在等待那一天的到来。
So the ruler of this island.He was also a son of Priyavrata. He had only 2 sons.
这个岛屿的统治者也是 Priyavrata 的儿子，他有两个儿子。
So he gave one side of the island to one son and one side to the other son.
这个 Priyavrata 的儿子，他有两个儿子，他把这个岛屿分为两个部分，一部分给予一个儿子，一部分给予另外一个儿子。
And then he also gave up.Material life entered into samadhi.
当他把这个岛屿给予儿子之后，他也退休，然后进入到萨玛底。
So to fulfill, to satisfy the material desires, the inhabitants of this island worship Lord Brahma.
为了满足物质的欲望，这片土地上的居民，他们崇拜主 Brahma.
And they worship him as the personality of Godhead. Of course, they know he's not the full supreme personality of Godhead, but they know he's a part of the supreme personality.
他们崇拜以主 Brahma 为代表的至尊人格首身，当然他们不认为主 Brahma 是至尊人格首身本人，他们是认为 Brahma 是至尊人格首身的一部分。
So they worship Lord Brahma as Karma Maya.
他们称主 Brahma 为 Karma Maya. Karma Maya.
Karma Maya means a form of ritualistic ceremony.
这个名字的意思是仪式典礼的形体。
So the Vedic hymns, they came from him.
From
Brahma. Brahma is a devotee of the Supreme Lord.
主 Brahma 是至尊主的一个奉献者。
So because he's a devotee, he's not different from the Lord.
因为他是至尊主的奉献者，所以他和至尊主也没有区别，也没有分别。
We should always be a servant of the Lord.
我们应该总是成为至尊主的仆人。
So we always want to remain a servant. We want to offer our obeisances to Lord Brahma, the form of Vedic knowledge.
因此，我们应该总是想着成为至尊主的仆人。我们应该总是崇拜主 Brahma， 他是伟达知识形体的展示。
And if you are able to do all the ritualistic ceremonies for 100 births, you can get the position of Lord Brahma.
如果你能够很完美的做100次伟达的这个仪式的话，你可以成为主 Brahma。
And although Brahma is very powerful, he never thinks of himself as God. He always remembers he's a servant of the Lord.
即便主 Brahma 极其的有力量，但他从不认为自己是至尊主本人。他从不认为跟至尊主本人合一。他总是想着他是至尊主的仆人。
So Brahma is also Bhagavan, the Supreme Lord.
在这种意义上讲，主 Brahma 也是 Bhagavan 至尊主。
He's the supreme servant of the Lord.
他是至尊主的仆人。
And if we serve him with faith, then we'll understand the meaning of all the Vedas.
如果我们全然的信心服务他，伟达文献的意义便可以揭示。
So his form, the form of Brahma is actually.All Vedic knowledge.
Brahma 的形体实际上展示的是所有的伟达知识。
So sometimes he's called Brahma Linga, means his body is all Vedic knowledge.
有些时候 Brahma 被称为 Brahma Linga, 指他的整个形体由伟达知识构成。
So beyond that ocean of sweet water, there's a mountain named Loka Loka.
在这个甜水之洋的外边有一个另一边有一个山叫做 Loka Loka 的山。
And this mountain divides the countries that are full of sunlight, and it divides it some, you know, on one side you have the countries which get a lot of all the sunlight, and you other side you get countries with no sunlight.
因为这座山它把阳光分成了两个部分。一个部分是充分有阳光照亮的一部分，另一部分是没有被阳光照亮的另一部分。
So then beyond the ocean of sweet water, there's another land, special land there, between the middle of Mount Sumeru and the Manasotara Mountain.
在甜水之洋的另一边是一片土地。宽度为苏梅鲁山的中央到 Manashotamara 山的边界那么宽。
嗯。Then there's another land which is made of gold.
还有另一块土地，它这个土地是由黄金构成。
So it reflects the light, becomes like the surface of a mirror.
由于这个黄金的表面，它像镜子一样反射着，反射着。
And anything which falls on that land, any object, physical object, if it falls on that land, you can never see it again because everything is just so bright. You just can't see anything.
因为那片土地由黄金构成，它的这个表面像镜子一样反射着光，任何落在那一片土地上的物体就不再被看到，因为那个全都是光。
So all the living entities, they left that land, they don't stay there, it's no good.
因此所有的生物体都放弃了那片土地。
But it's golden, the land is gold itself, but they don't want to stay there.
但是那片土地是黄金的土地，但是他们还是不想待在那儿。
So between the lands, some lands are inhabited and some land is not inhabited. So between them there's a big mountain.
在这个土地上的中，在这个土地上有一些有居民，有一些没有居民，在他们之间是一座巨山。
So this mountain has been made the border of the three worlds.
这座山山也被设置，由于这个山就有三个世界。
Yeah, it controls the rays of the sun.
它控制着所有的阳，它控制着阳光。
And all the stars in the sky, from the sun up to Dhruvaloka, they spread their rays through the three worlds.
从太阳到朱瓦洛卡的所有发光体在三个世界散布光线。
But only in the boundary formed by this mountain.
但也只是在这个山形成的界限之内。
Because the mountain is very high, it's even higher than Dhruvaloka.
因为这座山非常的高，它甚至超过了这个朱瓦洛卡。
And so it blocks all the rays of the stars in the sky.
遮住了所有的发光体的光线。
So Lokaloka Mountain is the boundary of all the lokas to distribute the sun rays.
因此 ，Lokaloka 是这三个的这个边界和外缘。
So Sukadeva Goswami is describing these affairs of the universe because he heard about them from his teachers.
Sukadeva Goswami 向我们描述的这个事实，因为他是从他先前的那些老师那里听到的。
He got this knowledge 5,000 years ago.
他五千年前就了解了这些知识。
But the knowledge was from a long time before that.
但这门知识在五千年之前还很久就存在了。
Yeah, he got the knowledge through the disciplic succession.
他是从师徒传系那里得到了这门知识。
But modern science, their knowledge is hardly 100 or more years old.
现在的这些科学知识只不过就是几百年而已。
So if the scientists don't follow,They won't follow Srimad Bhagavatam, so they can never understand this knowledge.
因为现在的科学家们，他们并不接受圣典博伽瓦坛，他们无法理解这些知识。
There's no information. There
也没有其他的信息。
In the modern science, they don't have any of this information.
在现在的这些科学里面，没有其他的 关于这些知识的信息。
They hardly know anything about the planet on which we're living.
他们很难以了解这些星球上到底居住着什么。
So, people, who, learned people, they don't make mistakes. They're free of illusion. They don't cheat. They don't have the four defects.
一个真正博学的人，他免于错误、幻象和欺骗。
And they will describe the planetary systems and their measurements, and they will give all the knowledge as it's here in the scriptures.
他们描述了这些星系的特征、大小以及位置。
So they say that the distance between Mount Sumeru and the mountain known as Loka Loka is equal to 1/4 of the diameter of the universe.
他们说，苏美尔山和洛卡洛卡山之间的这个距离是宇宙直径的四分之一。
That is a distance of 1,000 million miles. 1 billion miles.
换而言之，有十亿英里那么宽，十亿英里。
So, some devotees, they study all of this information and they use it to calculate more about the universe.
有一些奉行者，他们更多地学习了这个知识，以此来计算整个宇宙。
They know about the movement of the sun and the distance between the sun and the circumference of the universe.
他们知道这个太阳星球的运行以及太阳周边的这些距离给予的等等这些宇宙的这些信息。
But the technical information which is given in the Jyotirveda is very difficult to translate to English.
这些技术上的知识被记录在 Jyotirveda 很难以译成英文。
But if you read the Srimad Bhagavatam,They've given the Sanskrit words. If you know, you can read the Sanskrit.
如果我们读这个圣典博伽瓦坛的话，这些知识是以这个梵文的形式描述的。
Okay, so going ahead, on the top of Loka Loka Mountain, there are four big elephants.
在 Loka Loka 山顶上有四头非常大的大象。
And they're established in the four directions. Lord Brahma put them there in the four different directions.
主 Brahma 把这四头大象放在这几个地方，代表的是四个方位。
And these elephants, their job is to make sure to maintain the planetary systems of the universe.
这四头大象，他们负责维系整个宇宙的星系。
So the Supreme Lord, Personality of Godhead, He's the master of the spiritual sky. He's the Supreme Person, Bhagavan.
至尊人格守神是灵性天空之主，他是至尊的 Bhagavan.
And the demigods, they're under Indra, he's in charge of all the demigods. He's the king of heaven. And he's to look over the material world.
而以天地 Indra 为首的半神人则被以委托负责物质世界的事物的权利。他们只是这个物质世界的看守者。
And so in order to benefit those elephants and the four elephants and the demigods, the Lord, the Supreme Personality, will manifest himself on the top of that mountain in his spiritual body.
为了造福各式各样的星球的众生，也为了给那些大象，就是刚刚描述的那些大象增加力量和半神人给他们增加力量，至尊主本人在那个山顶上以他的灵性躯体展示着自己。
And when he appears, he comes along with all of his personal assistants and expansions.
当主亲自显现的时候，他和他的扩展和他的助手都一起显现。
And he has four hands and he carries the different weapons.
他有四个手，然后拿着四支不同四个不同的武器。
So he's decorated very nicely, very attractive. He comes in the form as Narayan or Vishnu, and he exhibits these forms just to maintain the planets.
至尊人格守神的这个形体，他以各种不同的武器装饰着自己的身体，他被称为 Narayan 和 Vishnu。同时展示这个形体也是为了维系他创造的这些星球。
And he maintains these different planets by his yoga maya potency.
他维系整个星球是通过他的 yoga maya 的能量。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna also describes, Sambhavami Atmamayaya, that I appear in my original, in my internal, by my internal potency, the Lord appears.
在《薄伽梵歌》中，主 Krishna 也说到，我以我的内在能量显现。
So after creation of the material world, that the world is created through yoga maya, the material creation is all done through yoga maya. So then the Supreme Lord maintains them.
当主通过 Yoga Maya 创造了这个物质世界之后，至尊主也在维系着他们。
He maintains them by his expansions in different forms, different expansions and also by forms as the demigods.
至尊主维系这个世界，也是通过他不同的扩展，或者说他不同的扩展出的这些半身。
So he will maintain the material world from the beginning to the end.
他从这个创造之初和一直到结尾一直维系着。
And he always maintains the spiritual world.
他总是维系着灵性世界。
So then outside the Loka mountain, there's an area of land called Alokavasa.
在Loka 山外面有一个地方叫 Alokavasa.
And beyond that Alokavasa is a place where people who want to get liberation go.
在 Alokavasa 外面是那些渴望从物质世界得到解脱的灵魂的目的地。
Yes, it's beyond the three modes of nature.
那里超越物质自然的本性。
Lord Krishna took Arjuna there.To bring back, there's a pastime. Lord Krishna went there with Arjuna.
有一个逍遥时光，主 Krishna 带着 Arjuna 也穿过了这一块地方。
It's described in the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam how one Brahmana, his wife, she was always having a miscarriage.
有一个这个在圣典薄伽瓦坛第十篇有描述。就是主 Krishna 带着 Arjuna 到了个地方，有一个婆罗门 ，he's always miscarriage.
Yeah, his wife with Lotan. They wanted a child, but she would have a miscarriage. Lotan, huh? 你明白吗？
Let me check.
Lotan.
他有一个婆罗门，婆罗门这个婆罗门的妻子总是流产。
Lotan, huh?So he went to the king of Dwarka to complain that this is your fault, you should protect my wife.
于是这个婆罗门就到杜尔洛卡就开始抱怨，他说您是这个国王，您应该保护我们。
I said, what kind of king are you? You're supposed to give protection.
您是怎样的一个国王啊？您应该给予我们保护。
So at that time Arjuna was there. So Arjuna bowed. He said, "I'm a Kshatriya. and said, when your wife delivers the next child, I will be there, I will protect.
当时阿尔朱娜也在那儿，阿尔朱娜听到他然后就发了一个誓，他说当你再生下一个要准备要生下一个小孩的时候，我一定在那里。
He said, if I cannot protect your child, I will give up my life.
如果我不能保护你的小孩的话，我会放弃我的生命。
So when the Brahmana's wife became pregnant again, Arjuna was there and he was waiting. He was going to protect the wife, make sure she delivered the child.
当这个婆罗门的妻子再次怀孕的时候，阿尔朱娜就在那里守候着，他想保护这个妻子，不至于她流产。
But still, the child, there was a miscarriage.
但是仍然这个妻子还是流产。
So Arjuna was in trouble. He was supposed to give up his life. He didn't know what to do. But Krishna was there, and Krishna said, don't give up your life. You come with me, we'll go and get the child back.
Arjuna 之前发下了这个誓言，所以他当时很尴尬，他应该立即就放弃他的躯体。但是主 Krishna 当时也在那儿。主 Krishna 说，你不要放弃你的躯体，你跟我一起到那个地方去，我们把孩子给追回来。
Yeah, and Krishna took Arjuna on his chariot, and they went through the coverings of the universe, and they went to the causal ocean, to where Mahavishnu was residing.
因此，主 Krishna 带着 Arjuna 带着战车穿过了这个宇宙，来到了 Mahavishnu 的这个地方，元婴之阳。
And they found the Brahmana's children, all the children who had miscarried, they were all there beside Mahavishnu.
他们找到了婆罗门的妻子的，他流产的这些孩子，所有的这些流产的孩子都在 Mahavishnu 的旁边。
Mahavishnu had been taking the children because he wanted Lord Krishna to come and see him.
Mahavishnu 把这些小孩给保管了起来，因为 Mahavishnu 想。主 Krishna 来看他。
So Krishna, even Mahavishnu is attracted to want to see Krishna.
即便是 Mahavishnu, 他也被主 Krishna 所吸引。
So the children were returned to Lord Krishna and Arjuna, and the Arjuna and Krishna, they brought them back to Dwarka and gave them to the Brahmana.
主 Krishna 和 Arjuna 就带着这些小孩回到了这个 Dwarka。
So, described here, this place is beyond the universe, and Krishna and Arjuna had gone there.
这个地方超越了宇宙，所以主 Krishna 和阿尔朱纳也去到过这个地方。
Okay, so then the sun is in the middle of the universe.
太阳处在整个宇宙的中央。
It's between Bhurloka and Bhuvarloka.
在布罗卡和布瓦罗卡之间。
And it tells us, we're told the distance between the sun and the circumference of the universe.
我们描述了宇宙的直径。
The distance is described 2 billion miles.
太阳和宇宙周围之间的这个距离是20亿英里。
So the sun is in the middle of the universe, and the distance between the sun and the edge of the universe is 2 billion miles.
之前我们描述的是宇宙的直径，前面讲了一个40英里，这里描述的是太阳和宇宙周围之间的距离是20亿英里。
So the sun god has another name. He's known as Vairaja.
太阳神的一个名字叫 Vairaja.
Means the total material body for all living entities.
意思是众生完整的物质躯体。
And because he entered this universe, so he's called.Mart Anda. Anda means egg. And like the universe is like an egg, and he entered into this egg of the universe. So he's called Mart Anda.
这个宇宙又被称为是一个蛋，太阳神也进入到这个宇宙之蛋，所以它又被称为 Mata Landa。
And he's also called Hiranyagarbha because he got his material body from Hiranyagarbha, Lord Brahma.
他也被称为 Hiranyagarbha, 因为他从主 Brahma 那里接受物质躯体。
So to get the position of Brahma, it's meant to be, you're supposed to be very highly, very advanced person.
如果要得到一个 Brahma 的职位，应该来说是一个非常崇高、灵性非常进步的灵魂。
So sometimes no qualified person is available. So then Lord Vishnu will take the place of Brahma.
有些时候，这样的生物难以找到的时候，至尊主本人，至尊主 Vishnu 也会把自己作为 Brahma。
But that's very uncommon for that to happen.
这样的事情很少发生。
So there are two kinds of Brahmas.
有两类 Brahma.
Sometimes Brahma is an ordinary living entity, and other times he's the Supreme Lord.
有些时候 Brahma 是位普通的生物，有一些其他的时候 Brahma 是至尊主本人。
But the Brahma described here, he's an ordinary Jiva. It's not.
这里所说的 Brahma 是一位普通的生物。
But.It doesn't matter if Brahma is the Supreme Lord or an ordinary Jiva, he can be known as Vairaja Brahma.
不管这个 Brahma 是一位普通的生物还是至尊人格守神本人，他都可以被称为 Vairaja Brahma.
And the sun god, he can also be accepted as Vairaja Brahma.
太阳神也可以被接受为 Vairaja Brahma.
So the sun god and the sun planet, they divide all the universe.
太阳神和太阳星球划分了宇宙。
It's only because of the sun we can understand where are the higher planets and where are the lower planets.
由于太阳的出现，只是由于太阳的出现，我们才能够明白哪一些是天空，哪一些是高等的星球。
And because of the sun, we know which place we can have more material enjoyment, and which are more hellish.
也是由于太阳，我们可以了解哪些地方可以用于物质享受，哪些地方是属于地狱。
Because demigods and humans, animals, birds.We all depend on the heat and light given by the sun god.
所有的生物，半神人、人类、动物、鸟类，所有这些生物都依靠太阳所给予的光和热量。
And it's because of the sun we're all able to see. Without the sunlight, we couldn't see anything.
也是由于太阳的出现，我们可以看得见事物。因为没有太阳的话，我们看不见任何东西。
So the sun god is also he's the god of sight. He presides over sight.
因此太阳也是主宰视觉的人格守神。
So the actual soul of all life in the universe is the sun.
整个宇宙中众生真正的生命和灵魂也是太阳。
And we worship the sun god when we chant Gayatri Mantra.
我们通过唱诵 Gayatri Mantra 崇拜半神人。
Right, the first line of our Gayatri Mantra is the Brahma Gayatri. That's how we worship the sun god.
我们唱诵的这个 Gayatri Mantra 也是 Brahma Gayatri. 我们通过这个来崇拜半神人，崇拜太阳神。
Om Bhurbhuva Svatat Savitu Varinyam Bhargo Devasya Dimahi. Like that. So Surya, the sun god.Is the life and soul of the universe.
Surya, 太阳神，是这个宇宙的生命和灵魂。
And there are many universes.
有很多，有无数的宇宙。
And the sun god is the life and soul.
对于他们来说，太阳神是生命和灵魂。
Just like the Supreme Personality of Godhead is the life and soul of the whole creation.
就像至尊人格守神是整个创造生命和灵魂。
So the Sun God entered the material planet called the Sun.
因此这个太阳神进入到这个物质创造被称为太阳。
So actually, there's a, the Sun God is living there on the Sun planet.
事实上，这个太阳神他居住在这个太阳上。
And Krishna gave this knowledge, Bhagavad Gita, to the Sun God.
Krishna 也把薄伽梵歌这门知识首先传授给了太阳神。
So living entities are living there on the Sun planet.
在太阳星球上也是有生物居住的。
One name is Vairaja, another name is Vivishwan, names for the sun god.
太阳神的名字一个叫 Vairaja, 另外一个名字叫 Vivaswan.
So the sun and the earth planet, the sun is fire planet, so different from this planet earth.
太阳星球上，太阳是一个火热的星球，它跟我们这个地球是有区别的。
But everybody has a body suitable for living on the sun planet. Everyone who lives there, they have to have a fire body.
而在太阳上，每那里居住的每一个人都有一个适合在那里居住的躯体。
Okay, so we'll stop there.
好，我们停在这儿。
Any questions?
Yes. Wait one minute.第一个问题，上周二剩下两个问题。第一个问题是来自 Akasha Devaka， 顶拜guru和翻译。我帮奉献者问个问题：对 Krishna 纯粹的爱，那是不是意味着抛弃丈夫的爱和对家人的爱，只追求灵性呢？Obeisance to Guru, I want to ask, the pure love to the Krishna is means to abandon the love to my husband and my family is only to spiritual is the pure love for Krishna.
Pure love for Krishna is to love all living entities.
对 Krishna 纯粹的爱意味着爱所有的生物。
So, not only love your husband, but you love all your children, you love everything, everyone, all forms of life. You see Krishna within everyone.
不仅仅是你的丈夫，包括所有的，包括你的孩子，包括所有的人。
So, love for Krishna.Is that you should take care of your duties. You have a husband, you have to take care of him, you have to please him, you have to show your love for him.
你有你的家人，你应该向他们展示你的爱，你应该履行你的职责，照顾他们。
You should not be neglectful to your duties.
不要忽视你的职责。
You have a husband, you have to please him.
你有你的丈夫，你得取悦你的丈夫。
And you have to also see him as part and parcel of Lord Krishna. He has Krishna in his heart.
你也得在你的丈夫身上看到他是 Krishna 的一部分， Krishna 也在你丈夫的心中。
So you have to try to develop love for Krishna. And that doesn't mean you have to disrespect your husband.
你发展对 Krishna 的爱并不意味着你不尊敬你的丈夫。
But you have to also observe the rules and regulations.
但是你也得尊敬这些规范和原则。
their duties, rules and regulations for people in household life, just like for brahmacharis and sannyasis, there's duties. There's also duty for grihasthas.
有对这个 Brahmana, 就是说 Brahmachari, Grihastha, 你也得履行你的这个居士身份的职责。
So you have to execute the duties, and you have to follow religious principles.
你得遵循这个做好居士的职责，然后也得遵循这个宗教的原则。
That is out of love for Krishna.
这也是属于这个对 Krishna 的爱。
All right.
Yeah. Next.
Yes.
Next from Chanchala Devi Dasi.Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru, 感恩翻译。Brahma 的妻子 Kaniya 的妻子，巴蒂王的妻子们，他们的丈夫都不是奉献者，那他们是如何成为 Krishna 的奉献者呢？ Obeisances to Guru, Brahma's wife, Kaniya's wife, and Bani Maharaj's wife, they are all not the devotees.But how they become Krishna's devotee?
No, Bali was a devotee. Bali is a great devotee.
She said Bali Maharaj's wife, they are not. They said this wife's, this husband, Bali Maharaj is a 奉献者.
So his wife certainly was also a devotee.
因此他们的妻子也是奉献者。
Although they were born in demon families, but still they were devotee.
即便他们在恶魔的家庭中出生，他们仍然是奉献者。
Now Kaliya's wives, they were devotees. How did they become devotees? Well, they heard about Krishna, and they were. They were convinced.
Kaliya 的妻子。他是怎么成为奉献者呢？他聆听过 Krishna.
They heard about the glories of Krishna from other devotees, and they became devotees.
他们从其他的奉献者那里聆听到有关 Krishna 的荣耀，然后成为了奉献者。
And they were telling their husband also to become a devotee, but he was not convinced.
这些妻子也告诉卡利亚。你应该成为奉献者，但是他们没有被，但是卡利亚没有被说服。
So after Krishna punished him by dancing on his heads, then Kaliya surrendered to Krishna and became a devotee.
当 Krishna 通过跳舞来惩罚这个卡利亚的时候，蛇之后，卡利亚才成为了奉献者。
And similarly, the Brahmana's wives, they were devotees. Their husbands, they were just ritualistic brahmanas.
这些婆罗门的妻子，这些婆罗门的妻子也是奉献者。这些婆罗门只是伟达仪式上的这些婆罗门。
How did his wives become devotees?
他们的妻子如何成为奉献者呢？
By special mercy of Krishna.
这是 Krishna 特别的仁慈。
They were attracted. They'd heard about Krishna and they wanted to meet him and be with him.
他们听说过 Krishna, 然后想跟 Krishna 在一起。
And their husbands, they regretted that they had not had devotion for Krishna.
这些婆罗门也感到非常的后悔，他们没有对 Krishna 的这种爱。
They appreciated that their wives were more fortunate than they were.
他们非常欣赏他们妻子比他们更加的幸运。
So it's like that.
所以就是这样。
You have to become a devotee. You have to get the mercy from some other devotees.
如果你要成为奉献者，你得得到 Krishna 奉献者的仁慈，其他奉献者的仁慈。
It's not that you have to get mercy from your husbands.
不是说你要从你的丈夫那里得到仁慈。
Can it just depend on your husband to make the wife a devotee?
仅仅依靠丈夫的仁慈不可能成为奉献者。
Sometimes the husband becomes a devotee first, sometimes the wife becomes a devotee first.
有些时候是丈夫先成为奉献者，有些时候是妻子先成为奉献者。
It's different. Sometimes they come become devotees together.
有些时候也是两个人一起成为奉献者。
The woman gets married to somebody who is not a devotee, then she has to make him a devotee.
有些时候女的成为奉献者，然后让丈夫成为奉献者。
Yeah, 结婚以后，她需要把她的老公成为奉献者。
当妻子成为奉献者，他们结婚之后，这个妻子得把丈夫变成奉献者。
下一个问题。
下一个问题 ，from Gita Govinda Mataji， 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和翻译。经典中经常提到的上中下三个星系是指 Buloka、Buvaloka 和 Svargaloka。In the obeisance to Guru， in the sutra， they mention always mention about the higher plane， the middle plane， and the lower plane。These three plane is the plant we mentioned today, the Buloka, Buvaloka, and Svargaloka, they are the same?
Yeah.
是的。
Yeah, when we chant our Gayatri mantra, Om Bur Buva, Bur Buva, that's these planetary systems within the universe.
我们唱诵的这个 Gayatri mantra 中的描述的布瓦布瓦，这个就是描述的宇宙中的这些三个星系。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question 也是来自于 Gita Govinda 顶拜 Guru 和翻译。今天提到的这些岛屿上的居民都崇拜相应的半神人作为至尊人格守神的一部分。那些生物体是属于半神人的奉献者还是主的奉献者呢？他们到达完美之后会去到哪里？ Obeisance to Guru. Today mentioned the habitants from this island. They worship different demigod, but they worship them as the part of the Supreme Lord. So I want to ask, this resident of this island, when they worship the demigod,Are they the devotee of the demigod or are they the devotee of the Supreme Lord? When they get the perfect, where they go?
They're devotees of the Supreme Lord and they'll go back to Godhead.
的奉献者，他们会回到至尊人格守神那里。
They'll go to Vaikuntha.
他们会去到 Vaikuntha 那里去。
Because they're in Dasharas.
他们是处于 Dasha Rasa 的这种心态。
Their mood is not spontaneous devotion. It's not, their qualification is not Raganuga Bhakti. Raganuga Bhakti is necessary to get into Goloka.
他们不是自发的奉爱服务的这种奉爱，而自发的奉爱服务的这种奉爱的情感才能去到 Goloka。
But they can go into Vaikuntha.
但是他们可以去到 Vaikuntha. Next question from the Chaitanya Charan Prabhu. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru. Prabhupada 说，托庇于 Krishna 的莲花足是解决所有物质问题的唯一方法。怎么样理解？ Obeisance to Guru, Gurudev. Prabhupada said, Srila Prabhupada said, take shelter of the Lotus feet of Lord Krishna is to solve all the material problems. Is the only way to solve all the material problems. How to understand this?
Yes. So take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna means that we have to engage ourselves in devotional service, which means engage in hearing and chanting about the glories of Krishna.
托庇于主 Krishna 莲花足意味着 对 Krishna 做奉献服务，这也意味着聆听和唱颂主 Krishna 的荣耀。
So by hearing and chanting the glories of Krishna, we will transcend all the miseries of material life.
通过聆听和唱颂主 Krishna 的荣耀，我们会改变我们的生活，变成灵性的生活。
The miseries of material life are due to identifying with the material body.
这个物质的生活主要的困惑的麻烦主要来自于我们对我们躯体的认同感。
But when you engage in devotional service by hearing and chanting about the Lord, you'll forget about all these miseries of the material body.
当我们聆听和唱颂主 Krishna 的荣耀的时候，我们会忘掉所有这些这个物质的躯体的麻烦。
You become so ecstatic, you become so absorbed in remembering and hearing about Krishna that you won't think anything about the body.
你会陷入到狂喜，你会完全沉浸到关于 Krishna 的荣耀之中，你不会再去想着这个物质躯体。
So that's what Prabhupada means.
所以这就是圣帕帕德的所要阐释的意义。
Material miseries are our ignorance. We're thinking we're suffering, but actually we're not suffering. The body is suffering, but we're not suffering. We're souls. The soul is blissful.
物质的痛苦意味着物质的痛苦是一种愚昧。实际上只是这个躯体在受苦，我们的灵魂并没有受苦，而我们是这个灵魂，灵魂是不会受苦的。
还有问题吗？
Wait one minute. 现在没有看到，萨提玛德姐正在 typing。
Hare Krishna, good day. 我正在打一个问题，但是我还是直接说吧。是这样，就是我们在这个修习的过程当中，学习经典，然后知道我们一世要想回归Krishna Loka。Krishna 的身边是非常非常困难的一件事情。那么我们应该是以什么样的心态呢？是把这种回归当成像解脱一样，并不在乎它的这个结果，就是认真的做每天该做的这个服务的这样一个心态呢？还是应该把回归当做我们这个明确的目标去？有这样的坚定的信心，我必须要这一世就回去，是应该是怎样的一个心态呢？
The main point is she want to clarify, should she really care about her? We should go back to the Godhead, or should we just be relaxed? We just do our service and the goal, the arrangement is by Krishna.
Well, no, we have to have the desire to want to go back to Godhead.
我们应该有这种要回归守神的愿望，渴望。
Just like Rupa Goswami describes qualifications for advancing in devotional service.
就像 Rupa Goswami 描述了在奉爱服务之中取得进步的一些特征。
So he talks about enthusiasm and confidence and patience.
他描述了热情、信心和耐心。
So we have to have some goal in mind. What is our goal?
我们得有我们的目标。我们的目标是什么？
Not that we just...Oh, it's okay, you know, if we just couldn't care less, then we won't be very enthusiastic. We would just be, we take everything as it comes and we won't be so much, and we'll be very, we won't have a lot of determination or enthusiasm for devotional service.
如果我们觉得一切都是很 okay 的，觉得没有什么，我们做就好了，那么呢，我们就不会有这种热情， 也不会有决心想要去做奉献服务，不会有热情，不会有决心。
And Srila Prabhupada writes in one purport, I think it's Bhagavad Gita, he says that one should be fascinated by the spiritual world.
Fascinating.
Yeah, fascinating means we're very strongly desiring to know more and want to go there.
圣帕帕德在《博迦梵歌》中的一个要旨中，一个世界的要旨中提到，我们应该要有非常强烈的渴望，要回到守身那里去。
And just like people here, they may hear about life in New York or Los Angeles or Hawaii, and they may think, "Oh, I would love to go there."
就像有人听到说，在美国纽约。洛杉矶或者夏威夷那样的生活，他会非常渴望想去到那里。
So the same with devotees, we should be fascinated by the spiritual world.
同样的道理，作为一个奉献者，想回到灵性世界的渴望，应该也达到这种强烈的渴望的境界。
So there has to be some effort on the part of the devotee that we want to actually achieve there, to go there, to be with Krishna.
这也是奉献者应该做的这个努力，要达到那里，要去到那里，要和 Krishna 在一起。
So we have to be a little cautious about being too, if you're too easygoing and you think, well, Krishna will, if Krishna wants, I'll go back to Godhead.We shouldn't be, you know, we would call this apathy. We think, well, it's up to Krishna, just leave everything up to Krishna. Yeah, it's up to Krishna, the final decision is up to Krishna. But we have to play our part. We have to want to be with Krishna.
我们也应该有意识地注意到这一点。就是说，确实在这个最终的结果是交给 Krishna 的。但是我们的这一部分的努力就是我们要去做好我们这一部分的努力。我们想要真的想要回到 Krishna 那里去，这是我们要做的我们这一部分的努力。
So you can't be too easygoing. You have to make some effort. We want to get love of Krishna. We have to make an effort. We have to really want it very much.I have to strongly desire.
不是一个很容易的事情，但是我们要做出巨大的努力，要有巨大的渴望，想要去到那里。
We should have, even they talk about the qualification to get it is greed, that you really want it very badly, and if you don't have that greed, you won't get it.
就像我们也谈到要去到那里，要有一个品质叫贪婪。贪婪的意思是你非常非常想要渴望去到那里，如果你没有这种贪婪的话，你不会去到那里。
Right, the qualification to get this love for Krishna, you have to be able to cry for Krishna, that you want it so badly that you'll cry for Krishna.
要得到这个 Krishna 的一个品质是你得非常渴望，你得为 Krishna 哭泣。
Of course, I mean, you could say, well, this is the mood of Goloka. Maybe you just want to go to Vaikuntha. If you're happy in Vaikuntha, then you don't have to have so much of the greed.
当然，这是 Goloka 的心态。如果你只是想去这个 Vaikuntha 的话，那里很快乐，你没必要拥有这么多的这种。贪婪的想要去到 Krishna 那里的愿望。
You just want to be devotee. You just want to go. So you can go to Vaikuntha. You can be there in Vaikuntha and serve Krishna.
如果你只是想成为一个奉献者，快乐的话，你可以去到 Vaikuntha.
Everything is done in Vaikuntha. You know, there's Krishna's worshipped with great respect and reverence.
Krishna 在 Vaikuntha 以巨大的尊敬和富裕在那里被崇拜。
But if you want to have the intimacy with Krishna and to enjoy the sweet dealings with Krishna, you have to develop this more spontaneous love for Krishna.
如果你要和 Krishna 发展出那种更亲密的更甜美的这种爱的话，你得发展出对 Krishna 自发的奉献。
So where do you want to go?
想问你，你到底想去哪里？
肯定想回归呀、啊。谢谢 Gurudev 的解答。
Okay, any other questions?
Yes, next from Chandravinasi. 请教 Gurudev 在阿格达西全戒时，把戒时的结果，给予家人或者给予 Guru 可以吗？对他们有哪些好处呢？ I want to ask, in the Ekadashi, we full fast, no water. We give this result to our family or the guru. Is that okay?
Well,
if I give to them, what the benefit they get?
Remember the real purpose of Ekadashi as a devotee.That we do this Ekadasi, the real purpose is to increase our remembrance of Krishna.
我们要记住阿格达西的真正的目的是增加我们对 Krishna 的记忆。
That you want to, you will do more chanting, and you will chant with more care and devotion.
我们更多的唱诵，我们唱诵的时候带着更多的分外。
Not that we just.Fasting.
不仅仅只是戒食。
Fasting, that's material.
戒食是物质的。
But chanting and serving Krishna, that is spiritual.
唱诵和服务 Krishna, 这个是灵性的。
So if you fasted on Ekadasi, then maybe your family gets some material benefit.
如果你在阿克达西戒食的话，你的家人或许会得到一些物质的好处。
But if you were chanting and praying to Krishna nicely, then they will get spiritual blessings.
如果你唱诵和唱诵 Krishna 的话，他们可以得到真正的好处。
So we encourage you, when you do full fasting, that you will do it to become deeper in Krishna consciousness.
我们希望如果你在做戒食或者说做全戒的话，你会更深入地进入到 Krishna 知觉之中。
Sometimes when people fast,They're so tired, they can't do anything, they just lay down and sleep, they hardly do anything all day.
有些时候人们做戒食，他们戒得太累了，只能躺着，然后一天躺在床上，什么事儿也干不了。
They don't chant hardly.
他们甚至不能好好的念诵。
So remember, the real purpose of the Ekadasi is to increase our devotion for Krishna.
请记住，阿格达西的真正目的是为了增加我们对 Krishna 的奉爱。
Means doing more hearing and chanting.
这意味着就是对 Krishna 增加的奉爱，这意味着更多的聆听和唱诵 Krishna.
Sometimes it means you have to cook, you have to make some nice foodstuffs and distribute to your family.
这有些时候还甚至意味着你得做更好的食物给你的家人。
Sometimes if the family see you fasting, it will put them off Krishna consciousness.
如果有些时候家人看到我们在戒食的时候，他并不欣赏，他甚至对这个 Krishna 知觉产生不好的感觉。
So you have to be careful.Try to make sure your family get a good impression about Krishna consciousness.
因此，你应该要在意一些，不要让你的家人对 Krishna 知觉有不好的印象。
Yeah, I hope, and you know, I'd like to think your children would become devotees.
我希望你的孩子也是成为奉献者。
If your children don't become devotees, it's not very good to you. It's not a good credit to you.
如果你的孩子不能够成为奉献者的话，对于你来说并不太好。
So duty of a parent is to raise their children that they will be devotees.
这就是父母的职责，就是要抚养孩子成为奉献者。
At least they should have a respect for the devotees.
至少他们应该尊敬奉献者。
But if they think, oh no, these people, they fast, they don't eat, they don't drink anything a whole day, oh horrible, I don't want to get involved with that.
他们如果看到你不吃不喝，他会觉得，哦，这些人又不吃又不喝又节食，我根本不想成为这样的人。
So be careful.
你得小心。
All right. Any other question?
Next, from the Radhisham Mataji, 顶拜 Guru, 顶拜翻译，请问在阿克达西鼻子嗅到了五谷食物的气体算破戒吗？ Obeisance to Guru, I want to ask, when in the Akadashi, when the nose feel, smell the grains, is that break the Akadashi?
No.
不，没有。
All right, any other question?
Not yet. 没有问题了。
我们没有问题了，我们已经停。
Okay, so we'll finish here. 我们今天讲讲，啊？
不对，我看一下啊。哦，Radha Priya有一个问题。
Okay.
顶拜 Guru。培养强烈的贪婪，想得到 Krishna。是内心的愿望，这会通过咕噜的仁慈获得，还是做更多的奉爱服务获得
？Yeah, so do we get greed for devotional service by the mercy of the guru or by our own
devotional service?
Yeah, so both are required, both the mercy of the guru and devotional service.
两个都需要，一个是孤儿的仁慈，另外一个是奉爱服务，两者都需要。
Yeah, just like Mother Yashoda was trying to tie up Krishna, but she was always too short by two fingers.
就像母亲亚修达想把 Krishna 给绑起来，总是差两个手指头的距离。
All right, one finger represents her own efforts, her own spiritual practice or sadhana, and the other was the mercy of Krishna.
一个手指头的距离代表了他自己的个人的努力，另外一个手指头的距离代表了 Krishna 的仁慈。
So in the same way, this greed, to cultivate this greed for devotional service, we need the mercy of the guru, and we need also our own spiritual practice.
同样的，要培养这种灵性上的贪婪，我们也要咕噜的仁慈，以及我们自己奉爱服务的。
Of course, guru doesn't necessarily just mean only Diksha guru. It may be Shiksha guru, maybe Prabhupada, the founder Acharya. You know, that's a real mercy coming from Prabhupada.
我们这里提到的 guru 并不一定指自己的启迪 guru， 还可以指训士 guru， 尤其是我们的创办灵性导师圣帕帕德。圣帕帕德从那里给予我们的是真正的仁慈。
We need mercy, but we can't just only depend on mercy. We have to also make some effort on our own part.
我们不能仅仅只是依靠仁慈，我们也要需要我们自身的努力。
Some people they think, oh, no mercy, give mercy, but you have to deserve the mercy.
有一些人说我没有仁慈，但是你也要配得上有仁慈才行。
So the mercy comes when we
那个时候仁慈，
When we are following, when we are really trying, endeavoring, then we please Krishna.
当仁慈来的，我们 真正的在努力，我们真正的在追随，我们真正的想要去取悦 Krishna 的时候，仁慈会来。
When Krishna sees us following this strictly, doing everything we're supposed to do, following strictly, then Krishna's pleased.
当我们很严格的追随，很严格的去做这些事情的时候，很想要去做的时候 ，Krishna 会被取悦。
Okay.
Next question from Sugita, Sangambadaji.
Oh.
Obeisance to Guru. Yeah. 顶拜 Guru, 感恩翻译。阿克达西日的目的是为了苦行，还是为了省出更多的时间读经典、读念诵曼陀罗呢？ Obeisance to Guru. The purpose of the Akadashi is to do the tapasya or to save more time to read the sutra and chant mantras.
The purpose of Akadasi is to increase our love for Krishna.
Akadasi's 目的是为了增加我们对 Krishna 的爱。
So we don't eat. You could say that, or we restrict our eating. We don't eat grains and we don't take beans on Akadasi.
我们在这个吃上有一些严格的这个限制，比如说我们不吃五谷，我们不吃豆类。
And so that's good for health because it's only once in 2 weeks it gives our stomach a rest.
这个对我们的身体也很有健康，因为在一个月只有两次，我们可以让我们的胃得的休息一下。
That we tend to often overeat, and so once every 2 weeks we can eat a bit less.
我们总是倾向于吃的更多。而在这两天的时候，我们可以吃的少一点。
And that way we can have more time. When we eat less, we have more time to read and chant.
当我们有更多、更我们吃的少一点的时候，我们就会有更多的时间。而这更多的时间，我们可以更多的唱诵和阅读。
And by reading and chanting, we will develop more love for Krishna.
通过阅读和唱诵，我们可以发展出对 Krishna 更多的爱。
So Ekadasi is a day which is very dear to Lord Krishna, and by observing Ekadasi, we can develop our love for Krishna.
Akadasi 这一天对于主 Krishna 是非常亲切的，而通过遵循 Akadasi, 我们可以发展出对 Krishna 的爱。
There is a famous pastime where some the devotees in the temple were all fasting for Ekadasi.But an invitation came for them to go to a program.
有一个逍遥时光，就是在这个庙宇，当时所有的奉献者都在戒食为这个阿格达西，但是呢，又有这个邀请，想要他们去参加一个节日活动。
So, the devotees said, "Oh, they said to Prabhupada, this was Prabhupada's spiritual master, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati."They said, we're all fasting today. We can't go to the program. So then he said, then cook prasadam, take prasadam, and then go to the program.
So, this is the time of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, Papa Ninhin 导师那个小时光，他们写信给这个Saraswati. 然后呢 这个Ninhin 导师就说，我们来做prasadam，我们带上prasadam，然后我们去参加节目。
So preaching is more important than the fasting.
因此，传教传播比这个戒食更重要。
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
Okay.
Any more questions?
No.
没有了 ，Gordon.
All right. 今天到这儿，感谢苏布里来给我们讲台的翻译，感谢萨提玛提吉主持，我们祝福大家，圣诞节快乐，
感谢古德，
新年快乐，
新年快乐，
节日快乐 ，Srila Prabhupada，
也祝你节日快乐。
Srila Prabhupada Vijay.
Jai.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.